God damn it. Instead of hitting the pause, like unpause hotkey, I hit the record button again and it stopped the recording. Sorry about that. It's only 5 o'clock. I'm surprised. It feels much, much later than that. I guess you just really, really get lost in this game, don't you? Alright, it shouldn't take us too long to get there. Like I said before, it looks, seems like Skellige is more of a... Not too... Well, I mean, I say that and all this area here is open, but a lot of the areas seem to be more linear and along a certain path. Bounce, kaboom, boom, bounce. All right, we're off and across the water here, or water, land. Took a shortcut.
Faster.
What the hell?
Slow now.
Excuse me. What? I heard somebody Master. Taking a really loud shit or something. It didn't sound like any golem or earth elemental to me. Jeez, what the fuck? Well, a fast travel point would be nice. Yeah, I'll be exploring these areas and doing the side shit at some point. No worries there.
You're mad, woman. Mad, I say.
Oh shit, what's going on?
A good reason.
I hold Siri dear too. You know this.
Yes.
The hell's going on?
Can hear you two clear on the other side of the island.
Oh, it's that guy with the sticks
good.
On his head.
May all Skellige know, Jennifer of Vengerberg is a common thief.
Control yourself, Druid. I haven't stolen anything. I've merely borrowed something and fully intend to return it.
Ha! The generosity. Just one small problem. Once used, the mask is rendered completely worthless. Not to mention the risk you'll bury us alive, and all the Isles with us.
Barry, what are you talking about?
Tell
She's
me.
She's not told you? Might have expected as much. The myth is that Urbarus created the mask when the envious seas swallowed his beloved. Unable to bear the prospect that he would never again see his betrothed, Urbarus made the mask, which would allow him to peer into the past. He knew, however, that he could only use it once. So he waited. Waited until his longing grew so strong that it became unbearable. When the sea learnt of the mask, it was quick to respond. It made known its threat that whosoever used the mask would bring the sea's wrath down on them. For in vengeance, the sea would rise and flood all the lands and drown the living.
Oh, bullshit. Anyone ever used it? Funny, because
mask?
It is.
Sailors from Clan Dimon pulled it from the sea, near the Njord Trench.
Yeah, but how can you be sure this is Urbaros' mask?
Oh shit, son.
Its appearance is exactly as described in the myths.
You believe the myths?
Only ignorant fools belittle their significance. Besides, it's not the myths that are on trial here. It's the thief.
I'm not about to justify what Yennefer did.
Then don't!
But try to understand her. She's not doing this to anger you, she's doing it for Ciri.
I know there are maternal feelings at play, but this is no excuse, no justification. The Mask of Urbaros belongs to Skellige, and should be used for the good of the Isles. If Yennefer uses it now, it shall lose its power, not to mention...
Holy fucking shit!
What was that? No. Yennefer's used the mask.
Oh my god, it's everything's going to shit. It really is going to shit. The myth was true. And this is where we believe Ciri made some explosion. Oh crap, it's getting... Yeah, look at this, it's like flood water coming down. Oh, this is gonna be awesome. Oh, they're good. They must be trying to take the power away or whatever.
Great. What was that?
Unicorns.
What?
Damn it, Yenna. I saw the foglets. I meant how'd they get here.
The power of the mask summoned them.
Ermion says the mask might cause a natural disaster.
Fortunate he's here, then. He can jump right in. Try to tame it.
Realize he won't let this pass.
Oh, I'll survive. Somehow.
What now?
The mask reveals the past, but only in certain places. Places where past events left a strong magical imprint. Take it.
Want me to wear it?
Yes. I'll cast a spell that will let me see through your eyes.
Oh, great.
Gonna read my mind again?
You object?
You do it whenever you want, anyway.
No harm in it, then, is there?
Wow.
Let's go.
She got beautiful eyes, though, I gotta say.
Already found the first spot.
Yeah.
This is the spot. Put on the mask.
Instructions?
Keep it on until you've seen everything. And don't stray far. Telepathy is limited in range.
There's people here.
What's that? A portal?
Two people emerged from it.
The woman was Ciri.
How can you know?
The way she moved, like a witcher. Seems they went that way.
Come, let's find the next spot.
Oh, it didn't look like I saw her boobs and stuff. Ah, piss.
Ready? Use the mask. Watch out!
What?
What was that?
A magic explosion of some sort. So powerful that even the echo was dangerous. I wager it destroyed the forest.
But Ciri and her companion weren't harmed. I saw them escape.
Let's see where to.
This way. This way. Another foglet.
The place is creepy. I don't like it.
Nor do I.
Anyone here when this happened had a slim chance of surviving.
Don the mask.
What?
Someone chased Ciri. See that? Might have wounded her.
Damn right.
She escaped through another portal.
Know where it led?
Magic residue trail leads to Velen.
What?
Any chance you can figure out where Ciri's companion fled to? His portal's gotta be nearby.
I'll try to find it. Come.
Velen?
Well, ready? Use the mark.
Nice fight.
One repelled the other with powerful magic, then fled through a portal.
A mage?
Most likely.
That one mage. Was it that one mage that was trying to contact Ciri or whatever? I don't know. Fuck.
It's Ciri's companion and the one who wounded her.
How do you know?
I don't. Making an educated guess. They both appeared in the previous visions.
Ciri's got a powerful ally. The mage who was with Ciri fled too. Nowhere?
His trace path leads to Velen as well, but the target coordinates of his portal differ from those of Ciri's. The explosion must have disrupted his teleportation.
Ran into Kira Metz and Velen. Coincidence maybe, but she claimed a mage came to her looking for Ciri. Be surprised if it wasn't the same one.
Whoever he
it's
is,
all connecting.
More interesting by the minute.
Maybe something left of the one who got hit by the spell.
It's clearing up.
Ermion must be getting a handle on the weather.
Which means he'll be free to attack us again.
Are you pleased with yourselves? Look at what you've brought down on us. If someone's death were to help you find Ciri, would you start making human sacrifices as well?
Just so happens I'm willing to do anything for some people.
Everyone else. Everything else be damned, is that it?
Stop panicking! Here's your mask.
It is worthless. It's an unwieldy ashtray at best. I hope you've learned something useful at least.
Very.
I'm talking to Geralt. You. You I'll deal with later. So?
We think a powerful curse was cast here.
Plausible. Considering what happened to the wood, do you know upon whom?
Not yet, but we know Ciri was here. She stepped out of the portal. A mage was with her. Someone chased them. They fought. Ciri was wounded, but managed to escape.
Where to?
Velen, probably. The mage opened a portal for her, then he fought her attacker.
Yes? Is that it?
Oh, wait, wait. So there's three different people. She had a companion that then attacked her, and she went in a portal, and then there was somebody else that came, attacked her attacker, and that's the mage. Is that what I'm supposed to be understanding here?
Got a feeling we found something interesting. Just need to examine one more thing. Something's pinned under that tree. Can you...
I can.
Oh god, is it Ciri?
Armor's clean.
No oh my
blood,
god, it's...
No sword nicks.
It's...
Ciri's friend must have...
White...
What do you call it?
It's the fuck...
Vaporized him.
Oh,
exquisite.
Vaporized.
The armor. All the workmanship's unfamiliar. Can't even tell
it's
where
the,
it's from.
The Wild Hunt, isn't it?
Probably because it belonged to a rider of the Wild Hunt.
Dun dun dun.
So it's true? The Wild Hunt? I feared as much. First here... Then on Hindersfjall. What did they want?
They're looking for Ciri.
But why?
Elder blood flows in Ciri's veins.
Tis true, she can trace her lineage clear back to Lara Durin, which is why the women in her family have always had extraordinary abilities. But could that truly be so important?
Ciri's exceptional. She travels between places here and other worlds. Space is no obstacle for her.
Huh?
Which is why the Wild Hunt wants to capture her. Speaking of the hunt, mentioned it appeared on Hindersfjall.
Well, it happened at least a fortnight after the cataclysm struck here on Ardskelling. The raids raided Lofoten, A dusk in a blizzard. Itself a strange occurrence for that time of year. The islanders said the wraiths. They barged into their huts, killed anyone who resisted, then galloped inland, laughing fiendishly.
Anyone survive?
A dozen or so women and an old man.
Next stop, Hindersfjall.
I'll meet you on the beach near Lofoten.
Wait, can't we go together? Right now?
But you detest being teleported.
Don't exactly like potions either, but I drink them when I have to.
You also drink them when there's no need at all. Very well. Let's go. Stay close to me.
I'd assume this is part of the quest.
Inform me once you've learned anything new.
Quite a few years since I was last on Hindersfjall.
Well, now that was quest completed.
But if I remember correctly, Lofoten should be this way.
Shit. I wasn't ready to do another quest now. I just thought it was all the same quest.
Raised huts and fresh graves. This must be it.
Gathering of some kind. We've come at a bad time.
There's no good time to talk about the Wild Hunt.
Hold on a minute. Looks like I might be having to take a break and or call the session here in just a little bit. So I'll see what I can do while we're here. Yeah, look at this. It's got all the white frost shit everywhere.
Ritual of some kind. We'll have to wait.
We'll do no such thing.
Yennefer?
Dear sisters, pardon the interruption, but we've an important matter to discuss.
Can you not see we're commemorating the dead? So?
And we're looking for someone who's still alive. Please, this is urgent. Then speak.
They say the Wild Hunt destroyed this village.
That is true, though few believe us. You don't either, I'm sure. Did you see riders on skeleton horses, wearing frost-covered armor?
Aye, that's how it was. They landed on our shores in a ship made of the claws of dead men, like in the ballads. Leif yelled to grab the children. Then they came, cut him across his face. He tried to whisper, only blood came out.
You were to ask about someone, not prod their wounds. That's enough. What happened then?
Go on.
I ran out. To get help. To get Leif. But so many bodies. Yole. Ingvar. Little Neki.
Which way did the riders go?
Towards the sea. Through the ravine. On horses made of bones. Bones and ice and...
Enough! Get to the point. Now.
We're looking for a young woman, name of Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes.
I'm sorry. She's not here.
Unless she lies in a grave. That is, I do not recall one by that name. But I buried so many, I may have forgotten.
This Ciri. Has she a scar? Here on her cheek.
Yes. Yes, what happened to her?
Don't know. Saw her but for a moment. Right before it all. She was in the stables. With Craven. 1,000 curses upon him.
Remember anything else? Anything at all?
Only that she seemed tired. Very tired. And her hair was wet.
Great.
Oh, okay.
So we know she bathed. Progress.
I'm sorry, Craven. My apologies. Craven. Craven could have told you more.
So he went by a different name.
This Craven you mentioned, does he have a name?
He did. Until the elders struck him from the saga of ancestors.
It's as if he has ceased to exist. The lore forbids anyone from touching him, speaking to him, even uttering his name.
What did he do to deserve that?
That would explain it.
He fled from the Wild Hunt. He alone.
We need to talk to him, even if it's not in keeping with your customs.
You've come too late.
He went to the garden to fight Morkvag.
A coward who willingly seeks battle? Am I the only one who sees the contradiction?
That's why he did it. Craven knew he would prove the Elders wrong only if he killed Morkvarg.
And thus regain his honor and his name.
Trial by ordeal. Very Skellige.
I do not mock your lores. Please also respect ours.
Where is this holy garden?
Not far from here. North. We cultivated healing herbs there once.
And now?
Now we walk only as far as the tree the goddess planted. We place our offerings and make our pleas before it.
Those who venture below remain in the garden forever.
Why? Because of this weird...
Morkvarg. What's that?
Who, you mean?
The vilest man ever to inhabit Skellige. Nothing was ever sacred to him. He attacked his own clan's lands, took gold from Nilfgaard, killed children, pregnant women.
Know the type.
They said he feared only one thing, the wrath of the gods. Morkvarg sought to prove how wrong they were, so he sailed to Hindisfjall to ransack the goddess's garden. This was over a decade ago.
Archpriestess Ulva stood in his way. He thrust a blade between her ribs and cast her down in the mud.
Oh, God.
As her lifeblood left her, she cursed him. And Morkvarg transformed into...
Oh, of course. So it's not just a dude.
Yes, a monster. You've got some work to do.
Great.
I can get rid of Morkvarg. Don't know what he's turned into, but a silver sword should do the trick.
It's not that simple. There have been those who have bested Morkvarg, yet he always returns.
Oh god, it's Sin.
So, it's a complex curse. Meaning I need more information.
I understand, but I've told you all I know.
Speak with Toradar's son, Einar. He was in the garden when Morkvarg and his men attacked. He saw what happened. Of all the pilgrims there at the time, he alone escaped with his life. He settled in Larvik. You'll find him there at the landing, provided he's not out to sea when you arrive.
Thanks for your help.
I understand you intend to enter the garden. I dislike it when foreigners enter the sacred grounds, but so be it.
Custom demands pilgrims make an offering of their own blood before the tree. Craven surely did so. Unless he lacked not only courage, but respect for Freyr as well.
You needn't worry about us. Geralt and I always give the gods the respect they are due.
Alright, this quest seems a little deep, so before we get too far, I need to do a double check just to make sure that I have time to actually do it. So I will be right back once more. Alright guys, it seems that I don't have time at this very moment. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the session here. I know there's been a lot of cutoffs again this session, unfortunately. But don't worry, I'm not sure if I'll be back to do more today. If not, I will be doing more tomorrow. But as for right now, my current plan is I have to go and do some things. And then after that, I'll address how much time, assess how much time I have left. And see if I have time to play some more Witcher or... just go straight onto my War Thunder stuff and then go to sleep, even though I'm nowhere near tired yet. It's only 5:30 something, so I'll probably have at least another hour to 2 hours, maybe 3 hours if we're lucky, to play this game if it comes down to it. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next session of The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt.